तन्नाम रूप चरितादि सुकीर्तनानु स्मृत्वा कमेन रसना मनसि नियज तिष्ठन् व्रजे तदनुरागि जनानुगामी कालम नैदखिलमिति उपदेश सारम। श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद ठोल माथुर विरह ब्रजवासी गणेर सेवा हमारे जीवन उद्देश्य टू सर्व दोज ब्रजवासी दोज आर नेम्ड एज माथुर विरह दे आर सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम मथुरा कृष्ण कृष्ण गण टू मथुरा टू सर्व दोज मथुर विरह ब्रजवासी इज आवर ओनली ड्यूटी वी गोवरियस इट इज स्टैम्प्ड एंड अप्रूव्ड बाय ऑल गुरुवर्ग नो अदर ओपिनियन कैन बी देयर टू सर्व माथुर विरह ब्रजवासी इज द ओनली ड्यूटी वी हैव वी गौरियस द श्लोक आई स्टार्टेड विथ एक्चुअली वी गेट दिस श्लोक फ्रॉम रूप गोस्वामी पाद आई कम टू दिस पॉइंट आफ्टर बट यस्टरडे आई वॉज discussing so many points to get the idea of Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. First of all, I must clarify those points, and also you can remember the yesterday I started with one sloka. You can remember you couldn't understand properly. त्वं भक्ति योग परिभावित हृत्सरोज आससे सुतेक्षित पतनुनाथ पुंसम यद यद धियात उर्गाय विभावयति तत्तद बपू प्रणयसे सदनु गृहाय। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस श्लोका? यू कुडंट अंडरस्टैंड प्रॉपरली। त्वं यू ओ सुप्रीम लॉर्ड यू according to the quality of devotion, according to the quality of devotion, according to their affinity, you can express yourself in front of them. Like yesterday, I gave example in front of Tulsidas, Krishna came, no problem. But Tulsidas ji appealing, Prabhu, I like to see Ram Sarup. Because Ram is our Ishta, my Ishta. So could you please kindly show me Ram Sarup? Yes, why not? So I am Ram, I am Krishna also. So this way, this sloka speaking, Tvam Bhakti Yoga Paribhavito, not Bhavito. Bhavito, you cannot manipulate. You cannot calculate. If you can calculate, then Krishna become your servant. I told you. No question of manipulation, calculation, nothing, imagination, nothing. Betito bhavana varto, just chamatkar bharahu. Hridi sadda jale varam, saddate sa rasa mataha. Very excellent sloka. Who can interpret? Who can understand? Very, very excellent sloka. Actually, Prabhupada, actually, last moment when Prabhupada going to leave this material world, he was expressing deep, sorrow. That I came here in this material world to give that treasure. Anurukrita charing chirata karanaya vuttrana kalau samarpata unnata ujjala rasam savakti sriyam harihi purata sundara dhudikatam vasandivita sada hidaya kanda spurutupa sisachanandana. And Prabhupada also speaking, the reason for why I came in this material planet, I wanted to give the treasure, but I don't find any qualified person. Don't think that is our Guru Bhargava, they are not qualified. Don't think that way. Because they are his paraphernalia, actually personal associate. They are coming and going. Prabhupada, what Prabhupada meant to say, many time, many devotee, I can speak with them. But sometimes you heard, somebody is speaking. All those devotee, those who took Diksha and Harinam from Prabhupada, they are all his personal associate. I told, it cannot be so. Why? Why? Why you protest? This is not protest. This is no question of protest. I have no agitation in my heart so that I can go, ditya have, mantra have. No slogan there. But it's a question of Siddhanta. It's Siddhanta. Because already in you can find Prabhupada Ashtakam. Patito dharane krita vesha jatim. Those who have fallen so, for them Prabhupada came, he took sannyas, bestowed kripa, giving full kripa to them to bring them up to level so that they can understand, they can get bhakti actually. So this, then the Prabhupada Ashtakam, I will have to throw it Ashtakam into Ganga. If I agree that all devotees, those who took Diksha and Harinam from Prabhupada, they are all as personal associated with Prabhupada, it cannot be so. Otherwise, what for he is coming in this material planet? Huh? Why he come? If fallen soul is not delivered, for why? What the reason behind? Why he come here? No reason. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming here? To deliver fallen soul? But they don't agree, they fight. It's a question of Siddhanta, you see. So Prabhupada told, I from Himalaya, the from north to south up to east, Indian Ocean, I travel across this Indian soil. But I don't find even a single person who is just 100% perfect, whom I can give this treasure. All his personal associates, not to speak about them. They are all coming with Prabhupada and going. They can have their quality. So, a deep sorrow expressed by Prabhupada. Oh, really sorry. Now think about it. How costly this property is, which the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give her. Valuation, you know? Valuation? The property, the treasure you want to get, you know his valuation? I can joke with you, you can go through the Gaurgisar Babaji Maharaj's life history. One day, one man came, paid dandavat. What for you come? Actually to apprise you that I got 2 katha land here in Navadvip. Gaurgisar, 2 katha land? How you got? It's that much amount, where from you arrange? Even this infinity world, if I sell, still it is not equal to that valuation. One dust particle is so costly that Brahma cannot buy it. Brahma can apple. Oh God, please excuse me. Gane prayasa mudapasya namanti eva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam sthane sthita sutigatam tanuvang manovhir. This stroke, Brahma. That much Brahma can say. Brahma can say, put challenge. I can take one dust particle. Who can say? How much cost? 10 rupees, 20 rupees? No. You cannot imagine it. So it's so costly treasure. You have possibility to get it because you are in Gaudiya Bhajan and the line of discipline going Prabhupada. 100% possibility, but you are losing. 100% possibility there. At all, if you are interested to follow exact track, then 100% possibility like otherwise not. Rasa, 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 rasa. Those who are thinking about jara rasa, how they can understand aprakita rasa? If you make confusion between jara rasa and aprakita rasa, then you would be heavily punished. Why you think that way? Why you run that way? Why you don't follow a pure Vaishnava? That is your responsibility. Yeah, there is big problem. You know, at the bank of river, at the bank of a lake, if you stand, then you can see your head is down and your leg is more nearer to your body. Because reflection, perverted reflection there in water. One tree is there. You can find the tree. What's that? Is all branches and leaf down. And the root is more near to me. The same example I can put regarding rasa tapta. If you have your capacity to understand it, then you can come out successfully. Very secret siddhanta. Urdhva moolam madhav saksham. In Gita you can find one sloka. This samsara, the material world, is one kind of tree. It's one kind of, you can go through Gita. Even I am very strong. Even those Gauri devotees, they identify themselves as Gauri devotee. Really? Rupanugadara? Really? But they even don't know the exact, interpretation of Gita. Even if I ask them what you understand by Sutra, they cannot speak. Whereas in Gauri philosophy we can speak this way, Krishna Bhagavan can excuse me. Because this is 100% perfect. Gita is a preliminary teaching in Gauriya Bhajan. Why you speak this way? How you speak? How dare you speak that way? No. 100% I am speaking. You cannot prove I am speaking wrong Siddhanta. Can you prove? I can prove from Gita itself. There Gita you can find, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, actually, what I mean to say, Gita is the preliminary teachings in the way of Gauriya philosophy. I mean, before entrance into Gauriya philosophy. You think about what havoc, what big Siddhanta, yes, but yet, it is vital and most important. Though I speak as a preliminary teachings in the way of Gauriya Bhajan, I mean, before you get entry, you must get established in Gita teachings first. Otherwise, no entry. Trespassers will be persecuted. Trespassers will be persecuted. No allow. Really so. Some of you think, why you speak that way? Because in Gita, final outcome what you get? Final outcome. Sarva dharmam parityajya mam ekam saranam vaja vaham tvam sarva papigyo mokshay swami mascha. Don't repent. You need not cry. Already my standing promise is there. I am going to deliver you. Provided you are 100% inclined to me. Are you inclined? Are you inclined? You are inclined 100%? Then. So this is the gate. So directly I have no scope. Directly I have no scope to prove my inclination unto the lotus feet of Krishna, because I cannot see Krishna in front of me. But, well, I can see my Gurudev. I can see my Gurudev. He is, you see, in Guru Vastakam, Shakshad Haritena Samasta Saste, Ruktastata Bhabbate Vasadvi, Kintu Pubharyo Piyavatasya Bande Gurasi Charana. So this is the Siddhant. Krishna speaking, Guru, who is Guru? Who is Guru? Krishna Bhagavan saying, I am Guru. I am coming. I myself coming in front of you as Guru. Who is Guru? Sadguru. Not I am speaking all standard word. You cannot confuse. I am speaking all standard thing. I am not going to explain about what is Asadguru, Sadguru. I already told Sat and Asad. I explained for 5-7 days. So I think you have some idea about it. Sadguru Lakshan, what all are the symptoms of Sadguru? Already there in Hari Bhakti Vilas, given by, compiled by Sanatana Goswami. So, well, you can go through, and you can take the travel to go through. And you can, if you cannot understand, you can approach me or Bharti Maharaj as you like. They can explain. Then, Krishna speaking, Krishna mam vijaniyat. Mam vijaniyat. Acharya mam vijaniyat. Krishna speaking, Acharya mam vijaniyat. Vijaniyat means you must know. Vijaniyat means special. There is prefix. Before, when Sanskrit some words are there, before, I think you understand. You understand. You don't know. Actually, Sanskrit grammar is very sweet, very complicated, yet very. There is some prefix there, some prefix. In Sanskrit grammar, you can, before one word, if you use some prefix, I can show you the example. Like pro, para, apo, onu, odhi, nu, that kind of. All prefix, once it seems, is very simple prefix. What does it mean? But in Sanskrit grammar it is written, very dangerous thing. In Sanskrit is written grammar, Uposargena dhatyartho balad annatra niyate. Sanskrit. Uposargena dhatvartho balad annotranyati. If you even use one simple prefix, pro, para, then word change, totally, meaning change. Like I give example, those who are Indian devotees, they go through some grammar, you see, they can understand. Ahara, bihara, prahara, sanghara. Ahar, Bihar, Prahar, Sanghar. Dhatu? Har. Ahar. Prohar. Sanghar. Meaning heaven and earth? Ahar means I am eating. Prohar means I can beat. Sanghar means I can kill you. Almost same. But meaning heaven and earth difference. You can go mad. So scientific this grammar is. So Acharya mam bijaniyat. You must know it for sure, 100%. I myself acting as Acharya. Prabhupada also speaking so many things. Now you see there is no difference between Krishna and Acharya. I mean, practicing Acharya, Paramahansa Acharya, those were. Now you go back to the starting point. I told you, Gita is the preliminary teachings in the way of Gaudiya Bhajan. I mean, before you get entry into Gaudiya Bhajan, you must get established in Gita Bhajan. 100% true. Because in Gaudiya Bhajan also, you go through assemblies, everywhere you can find. Same thing. Shikhaya saranagati bhaktera pran. I explained this point in Puri also. Sikhata. The vitals of your bhajan, vital of your life is saranagati. If there is no saranagati, you can shout, you can memorize all scripture, you can exhibit that you are following a pure Vaishnava. No use. You would be, no result. The saranagati is the entrance where Gita end is teaching, then Gauriya philosophy start. Where Gita ends, Gita end, the final teachings, Gita. Then Gauriya philosophy is their starting point, entry. Now you see what peak. So nobody interested to go through the teachings of Gita perfectly, scientifically, under the guidance of pure Vaishnava, they can specify. How excellent interpretation given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. There are so many commentary, more than 400, 500 commentary, authentic or unauthentic. You can calculate more than 500. I think 500 is nothing, maybe 800 like that. But authentic Bhagavatam, 18 commentary you can do. Authentic. Gita, Siddha, Saipa, Vishwana, Chakradeva, Valadev, Vidhavasan, so many. Ballavacharya, Madhacharya, Ramanujacharya, they all give. Even if there is no Gita commentary in their disciplic order, then that sampradaya is not authentic. They think so. That's why they wanted to fight with Gaudiya devotees. Why you come here to prove that you Gaudiyas are, you have no Gita commentary, you have no Vedanta Bhasa. Why you say you are not? Then Baladev Vidyasam crying all day and night in front of Govinda. You Govinda, you come in the in front of us at Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You. Now you say they are going to insult us. We don't have commentary. Govinda laughing. Oh Baladev, get up. You get your pen and paper. I am speaking. You go on writing. Govinda speaking. Baladev, go on writing. I am speaking. Then like wind, Govinda speaking, Baladev, and Baladev with those writing combined. How is that possible? So shortly they get, Vedanta Sutra and go to them. We have, how? Yesterday you told, no, I have, today you say, well, we have. Oh, so excellent commentary. Baladev Vidyavasan commentary on Vedanta, topmost. Ramanuja is also doing so many, I think, no. Baladev, Ramanuja, Madhacharya, they all doing. But Baladev Vidyavasan commentary is topmost. Now I like to go back, because I like to give some idea about it, how dangerous thing we expect. So, Tvam Bhakti Yoga Parivhavita Hissarojo Asase Srutekshita Patha Nanunatha Pangsham Nanumit Nishchita Meva 100% sure. Nanumin Sanskrit 100%. There is no alternative. So first, Acharyaman Bijaniya, do you understand now? By now, I have idea. Now, about this sloka, you must ask, because this two sloka have some link. Why? Repeatedly I told, until and unless you cannot understand the bani feature of your Gurudeva and Vaishnava, then you are 100% failure. If you fail to understand the bani feature, blood and flesh, oh, so tall Maharaj, so fair complexion, oh, so nice, like real sadhu. And one Ashtavarka Muni is like, if you look, Ashtavarka Muni. But he is having Dibha Gyan. Ramchandra approached Ashtavarka Muni. Please kindly give Divya Gyan. Ramchandra don't have Divya Gyan. You think how Supreme Lord teaching us, how humble the mood of Krishna, how humble the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Trinada Vishnu Chinatara Vishesh. Amanana Madhana Kirtaniya Sadahari. If this formula is totally applied in your life, then be sure you are going to get entry into Rupanuga Vajan, Raganuga Vajan. Nobody can stop you. Nobody can go again. But Trinada Vishnu Chinatara, I cannot. I cannot. My Guru Maharaj used to laugh and speak. I wanted to become Vaishnava, but when I heard this sloka, I thought it is not possible for me to become Trinadapi. I can fight, I can show so much proficiency, I can show, but I cannot become Trinadapi. Not possible. Humbled in the blood of Vyas. Prabhupada explained this sloka. That's why I told you. The Sikkhastaka is the gist of all the scriptures. I mean, all the writings by our Guru Bhargava, I mean, Gosvami Bhargava, the gist. Because there you can find Sambandha Avidya Prayojan. The present status of Jivas. After that, the way, the excellent Kipap Nam. Then how to enter, then you can get Sambandha Avidya Prayojan. I can categorically, I can prove it categorically. Whole scripture, like 20 kg milk is there. In fire you are, after that it become 2 kg or 1 kg kira. So if you start, you can get cream. That's why our Guru Varga repeated it. So don't try to calculate anything. I told you repeatedly, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute. Nana sastva vicharanai kanipuno sadharma sangsthapako lokanam hitakarino tibhavane manyo saranyakaru. Why this slok? Then Guru Varga teaching us, you need not go through vast chapter, I mean different Shastra, because there is confusing Siddhanta. Maharaj, I got it from Patapuran. And it is written there, oh my God, it is written in Vishnu Puran. And in Bhagavatam I feel this way. So how I can tell? Useless, all useless. You can develop that kind of hatred. So it is good if I go to Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and get the cream. Very good. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur is seventh Goswami. Nana Sastra Vicharana Ikonipini is okay. Goswami Devi. After that is also then, after that again filtered and by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to represent Golok directly. If anybody can understand the gravity of Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, they can understand. If they have quality at all. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if you go through the writings of Bhaktivinoda, you can find Bhaktivinoda Thakur through his speech and writing wanted to represent the, transcendental world. Goloka. He wanted to show this. See, this Goloka. Is not possible. So now, Tvam Bhakti Yoga Parivhavito Hit Saroj Asase Sutekshita Patanonona Tupungsam Jad Jad Hiyat Urugaya Vibhavayati Tat Tad Bapu Pranayase Sadanu Grahayo Tvam Bhakti Yoga Parivhavito Hit Saroj Asase Sutekshita patanunanatu pungsam Yad yad dhiyat urugaya vibhavayati Tat tad vapupanayase sadanu grahayo. If you understand this sloka, all confusion gone. First of all, Guru Tattva, you just explain a little. Previously I told Satanasa. Now, until and unless you can understand the bani feature of your Gurudev, then you are not at all disciple. Authentic disciple. Bani Sharu. So now come to the point this sloka. Sutekshita patana nanartha pungsam. Same, na? Sutekshito. Suto means first try to get those bani through your oral reception. Try to catch. It is antenna. Transcendental antenna. Okay. Then you can see. What do you mean? Yes. In material world, you can go outside and you can put on your spec and try to see what is happening all around. But in transcendental world, not like that. You are blind. You will have to depend upon the bani feature of Guru Varga, I mean Vaishnava and Guru. Bani feature. Then you have to depend upon. Sometimes some devotee coming to Prabhupada in Mutt, I mean Gaudiya Mutt. Prabhupada, can you allow this new devotee, can you allow us to speak some special thing to them about Gaudiya Bhajan? Prabhupada said, well, stop now. Why? But he's not, he has no quality to catch it. First, allow him to hear Kirtan, Kirtan, Kirtan. Let him do Kirtan and hear Kirtan and Harikatha. And shortly you can find you are developing quality to catch that kind of aprakita siddhanta. Otherwise useless. Useless is the siddhanta Prabhupada. Don't speak right now. All the vitals of Gaudiya Bhajan, he cannot digest it and all dysentery can happen in his life. All dysentery, you are eating so much. So what use? No assimilation, no digestion, no assimilation. Your body collapse. What use? No practical practicality. Now, first of all, I say, Shutekshita patan ununartha pungsham. So, you must depend upon the speech of Guru Vaishnava. I mean, those Guru Vaishnava do 100% established in Siddhanta, like fire Harikatha coming. They are never memorizing anything. Their life itself, Bhagavatam is there. In their character, you can find, and I think they are Bhagavatam. You need not read Bhagavatam. You stay with them, you can see, wow, vivid example. Vivid example. Their life itself, Bhagavatam. All there in Bhagavatam, it is applied from, you can find in the life of that devotee, I mean pure devotee, Paramahansa. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj cannot read Bhagavatam, cannot explain. Foolish. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj exactly knowing the, I mean the meaning of Bhagavatam. Yes. So, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj's whole life is the applied form of Bhagavatam. Someday our Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami went to Kuliyadip to meet Gurudev, Paramahansa Gurudev. But Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj wanted to cheat everybody. He entered into the Latin room and sitting inside and doing Harinam. Anybody coming, oh, Babaji Maharaj gone, the latrine, nobody can disturb. Now, Prabhupada coming, he heard Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj enter into latrine, he is doing bhajan there. Bhajan or in latrine? Then Prabhupada approached the gate of latrine. Babaji Maharaj, Babaji Maharaj, who that? I am your servant. I am Bimala Prasad. Also you like to cheat me? Eh? Also you like to cheat me? Oh, you are? Then you open the gate and embrace him. Oh, let us go and sit. Then Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj asking, my Prabhu, can you quote one sloka from Bhagavatam? Yes, why not? Yeah, speak so. One sloka, Prabhupada reciting one sloka. Can you explain this sloka in front of me so that I can understand something? Babaji Maharaj, if your mercy is there with me, well, I can explain. Then he went on explaining this sloka so nicely. After nice explanation, Gaurudasar Babaji Maharaj speaking. Oh, so nice explanation. Nobody can expect that kind of explanation. Well, Bimala Prasad Prabhu, if I explain this sloka this way, do you think it is okay or not? Then Gaurudasar Babaji Maharaj started explaining this sloka again. Gaurudasar Babaji Maharaj asking, my Prabhu, if I can explain this sloka, if the sloka can be interpreted this way, explained this way, is it wrong or good? Then Gaurudasar Babaji Maharaj started explaining. After explaining, then Prabhupada, how is that possible? Material people speaking, Gaurudasar Babaji Maharaj is not educated, he is not knowing anything about Bhagavatam. But how is that possible to explain this sloka that way? Then Prabhupada giving one a comment. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is sitting inside his heart, is there any deficiency of knowledge? Complete knowledge is there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sitting inside their heart, say everything is possible for me. One example also I cite sometime during Harikatha, they laugh. One day, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj giving order to his seva, who? Bihari. Hey Bihari, bring Bhagavatam. Bring Bhagavatam. Oh Babaji Maharaj, here is Bhagavatam. Read it. I am illiterate, you know. I am illiterate, you know. How I can read? I say, you read. How I can read? Illiterate I am. You read. Then you open. He went on reading. Oh God. He went on reading. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, go, read. Everything is possible if you enjoy the kripa of Guru Varga. Paramahansa Guru Varga can give you full treasure. But we should develop that kind of quality. There should not be any master here. There should not be any politics. Otherwise you should lead that society in which you are put into. Because Guru Vaishnava Antaryami, they can know everything what is happening where. They can understand the mood of all people. Who is speaking what behind them. Because Krishna is sitting inside their heart. Don't go for politics. You can die. So you see, what I wanted to speak, everything is possible. That day I told, one devotee came in front of Gaurudasar Babaji Maharaj. Why you come in front of me? I want to learn Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. Well, Raganuga Bhajan, okay, you come after. I have no time now. After some days, again he approached. Again, wife, you are coming. Well, I told that day, I come in front of you to learn Raganuga Bhajan. Actually, you see, I don't have time today. You come after. After 3, 4, 5 days, after cheating, then that man became, well, I'm coming in front of you repeatedly. You are saying, no time today. Then gone. After abusing him, speaking all rubbish. Then Babaji Maharaj speaking himself. Those who cannot live in even slightest interest in this material world, small interest they cannot live. They like to learn Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan. Well, what is the excellency there? They can buy all books from market and they can memorize. What problem it is? But where from that they can get that feeling? Where from they can get that direct feeling? Green banana. They cannot get any directly. Because it is only Shuddha Guru Vaishnava can give. Who can give? Nobody can give. Now I come back to this sloka. Now we can find why I speak that way. If you fail to understand the Bani Swarup or Guru Varga, then what use in your spiritual life? Bani Swarup you will have to hear from Shuddha Guru Vaishnava. Then after that, automatically you can develop darshan. Shutekshita Bhato. First you, first this hearing. First, Bhakti Anga, ninefold Bhakti. First Savan. First Savan. Then you can develop your eyes. First here. It can go into your heart, give full kippa, then you can develop your darshan. Then you can see appropriately. I mean, yathayatho. In Bengali and Sanskrit, we can speak yathayatho. That is, in English, we can say appropriate darshan. 100% perfect darshan. There should not be any aperture, any angle in your vision. I already explained this point. There should not be any angle, any aperture. If your darshan is totally open, if your darshan is totally free from any kind of impediments, any kind of barrier, any kind of maya, then you can look anything and everything. Paramahansa Gurudev can see past and future, everything, what you think inside. Because there is no barrier, no angle in their vision. Follow scientific. So first of all, you must have Rukhanuga Bhajan. Before that, you must understand this point. Otherwise, you can... Tvam Bhakti Yoga Paribhavito. Not Bhavito, not manipulation. Paribhavito, Paribhavito, exact feeling. Tadviddhi Panipathena Paripashnena Sevaya. Tadviddhi. Paripathena Paripashnena Sevaya. Upadikshanti Iti Jnanam Jnanina Stattva Darshana. They can transfer their heart and feeling as Siddhanta into your heart, provided you are 100% inclined, submission is perfect, you develop 100% serving mood. Panipat, Panipat means submission. Pro Yukto Pat. Pat means I fall down in front of prostrate at Dandavat. That is called Panipat. Panipat means there should not be any desire, any objective hidden inside your heart. It's very plain. I like to get Dibba Gyan. I want you deliver me. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Krishna himself. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, while taking Diksha from Ishwarpuri path, speaking, Ei ami deho tomai korinu samarpan, sangsar samudra hoite, from the ocean of this material world, please deliver me. Now I am inclined in front of you. I am just surrendered in front of you. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, speaking in front of Gurudev. Ei ami deho tomai korinu samarpan. Now I throw this body onto your lotus feet. Now please save me from this material. Supreme Lord exhibiting this way, showing this way. Now think, so vital thing, you see. So, paribhavito. Paribhavito means exact feeling should be there. Exact feeling. I mean, after hearing from Guru Varga, Guru, transcendental salvation, you develop your darshan, and then simultaneously I told you, darshan, I told you everything, hearing, darshan, and kirtan, all simultaneously. Simultaneously you can get. It's a simultaneous factor, you see. I can prove it from Bhagavatam after. So now, this sloka advise you, start canto from now. Sutekshita patanunu nata pungsam. Yajjad dhiyato urugaya vibhavayati. Those devotees, according to their bhava, because in Raganuga Bhajan, one secrecy is there, one key. What is that key? Sadhane sadive jaha siddhite paive taha. Narottama Thakur giving you the key. During your bhajan, what you are thinking, what you are exact feeling you are getting, While leaving your body, you can get that thing. That exact that thing. So be careful in a sudden life. In your sudden life, you must be very careful. Sadhane sadhive sadhan, sadhane sadhive jaha, siddhite paive taha. During a sudden life, what you get, what you feel, that is going to be implemented in your next life, while you are going to leave your body. So you follow. So, if you try to jump, there is no way out. Then after that, in sloka is written, then according to his bhava, what he developed inside, his heart, you manifest himself yourself accordingly. Like in Koladip, that side of river, one Brahmin was there, he is worshipping Varahadev day and night, oh Varahadev, oh Varahadev, Kipagara. After that, Varaha, like deep cloud color, blackish. Then Varahadev, not actually blackish, in front of Varahadev, like a big mountain with bhakti. Bhakti yoga paribhavito, bhakti yoga paribhavito, hitsaroj asase. First of all, through your bhajan, you can get Krishna inside your heart. Then Krishna can manifest himself outside. Dhruva Maharaj, what happened with Dhruva Maharaj? Dhruva Maharaj deeply meditating. Deeply meditating. Doing bhajan. Narayan coming in front of you, but still he cannot see. Because Narayan is there inside his heart. He is looking at Narayan. Narayan is sitting inside his heart. He need not look outside. Because he can take darshan inside. So, then Narayan thinking he is looking me inside. So he cannot open his eyes. So it's good. If I stop inside darshan, if I can stop his inside darshan, then he can look. Automatically Krishna stop inside the why? Where the darshan gone? And oh, what I see inside? Outside. Outside. Oh, then fall down. And so many sloka after. So you understand? According to the quality of your devotional affection, Krishna can manifest himself in front of you. Like that example I give in front of Varahadev, in front of Brahman, that Brahman, Varahadev, Krishna manifests himself as Varahadev. Keshavadhita. Sukara Rupa Jai Jagadhisa Hare. Krishna can take this, but it depends. Now, point is that I was so many big area I am discussing. I like to clarify this one. Big area. I am hovering around this center point, Raganuga Bhajan. Now, I like to go back to Allahabad, Arayal Gam, Ballavacharya's house. I was discussing. Ballavacharya's house. There I saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone there. With Rupa Goswami Pada and Anupam, Mahaprabhu gone there. He is receiving some seva from Ballavacharya. Well, he started. So previous this look clear to you? Tvang bhakti yoga puribhav hitsarajo asase. Sutekshita pato. First, you can see, you can hear, then you can develop darshan. Ikshito. Then you can see. Nonunato nishya. This is the procedure. You will have to depend upon shauta pantha. First of all, you understand. Then I like to go back to Allahabad because time is limited. Only 2 hours or 2.5 hours, 2.5 hours, nothing. It takes hours of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discussing, I mean, always singing and dancing, and Rai Ramananda, Swarup Damodar, always they three. Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, they are testing this rasa. But this rasa is endless rasa. Because Rupa Goswami Pada, when the teaching and giving by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean Rasa Tattva teaching was given to Rupa Pada. After that, finally Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking one thing, you must remember, don't forget it. What Mahaprabhu speaking? O Rup, Krishna is the ocean of beauty. Krishna is the ocean of Leela. Krishna is the ocean of Rasa. Krishna is the ocean of Rasa. Endless ocean. Infinite ocean. Just why I wanted to give you a little test. I wanted to give you a little test. How it... like you get your tongue outside to test. One drop I can. And that sloka Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explaining Chaitanya Charitamrita. Inside Gambhira, they're discussing all day and night. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu crying. He is Krishna himself, come on. But with Radha Bab, he is searching Krishna. He's searching Krishna. Raganuga Bhajan, you need not go to a cheetah. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but first you will have to learn that the efficacy of his Leela. Ambiguity. Very complicated. You cannot understand. So there, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I heard Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speak, I mean, I saw one nice place there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Mor mon sannipati sab pite kare moti duddhoi vaidyo nadai ek bindu. Sannipati, this is one kind of disease. Sannipati, if you develop Sannipati means you feel thirsty. Always. But duddhoi vaidyo, the doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, not allow you to drink. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking this philosophy. Mormo sannipati, shaktite karamadhi, the ocean of nectar of Chaitanya Leela, Krishna Leela, I mean, ocean of rasa. I want to drink all, like Agastya Muni, seven seas. Drink. Seven seas. I like to drink all the rasa, infinity rasa, but that doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, not allow me to give even a drop. I am helpless, what to do? So you see, duddhaiva vadya nada ek bindu. One drop I want. Mahaprabhu speaking, Rup, I wanted to give you a test. How a test I wanted to give you. And one drop, if one devotee, I mean, so if he can get one drop, then there shall be high tide, banya. Tomorrow we are going to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance day. Tomorrow, Abhirbhav Tithi. There you can find one nice sloka by Prabhudananda. There is a nectarian ocean and flood coming all throughout this universe. But I am so unlucky, I am not getting it. Povodhananda river. Nice sloka. Prasarito prema pichu, prasarito prema pichusha. Prasarito prema piyusha rasa sagare chaitanya chande prakate jo dina sa dina evasa. I regret for that personality, he is idiot, useless in this material world, who is not going to get this nectar, whereas there is a big flood all around. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving flood. Prasarito prema piyusha rasa sagare chaitanya chande prakate. Dino, so Dino, he is actually bad luck, useless. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu come this material world. There is flood of prema, but we are fighting, doing politics among you. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not so foolish that he is going to give you a Prakita Rasa. Those who are fighting cannot give. So Sikhaya Saranagati Bhaktirupa. There should be Saranagati first. Because after Saranagati, then you have the chance to hear Tadvidhi Punibad Paribhasana Seva. And Seva should be there simultaneously. Without Seva, if you like to get Tattva Siddhanta, my Guru Maharaj used to explain this point. After the swinging, I'm afraid if somebody can think I want Seva from them. They can think I am giving Harikatha, my Maharaj speaking, you must serve me. I mean to say it is written in Gita. What to do? Krishna Bhagavan speaking. Padbiddhi, Tadbiddhi, Paribhat, Paribhasana Sevaya. Upadekshanti to Gyanti Gyanam, Gyaninaha, Satadarshinaha. This is the procedure. Now there you can see in Allahabad, there Ballavacharya there, then his room, Arayal Gram, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reaching there. Then one Brahmin came in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, paid dandava. His name is Raghupati Upadhyay. Raghupati Upadhyay. Then Mahaprabhu can understand the heart of Raghupati. Mahaprabhu knows he is a pure devotee. Raghupati, then after some discussion, Raghupati, can you guide me about what sarupa Supreme Lord should be worshipped? Then Raghupati, he is Rasik Bhakta. He is having ras inside. Mahaprabhu knows. Then Raghupati Upadhyay speaking. Shyam eva param rupam. Shyam eva. Shyam rup. Shyam rup. Only we want Shyam rup. We must also, Aradha Bhagavan Vajasasthana Yastha Dhamma Vrindavanam. That's it. Shyam eva param rupam. Well, very nice Siddhanta to speak to me. Now can you teach me, Krishna can have different kind of age factor, dvaita transcendental. Which age you suggest? Sam eva param rupam bayo kaisarakam dheyam. Kaisarakam, adolescent, 16 year age. Regarding this 16 year age, there is fighting among so presumed devotees, the common devotee. 16 years? Krishna stayed there in Brajadam 11 years, some months. How 16 years you get? Huh? What is the solution? Jiva Goswami was giving solution, you see. Jiva Goswami was thinking, come on, why you are fighting? Actually, Krishna is the son of a king. You can find those who are in king family, they develop, their body is developed. Like if you, I can give you example, if you go to Punjab, they are all Rajputana. They can find in Rajasthan, Putana, their bodies develop. So, Jiva Goswami was giving solution. Actually, it is not actually age factor. It seems he is 16 years. More than 16 years. His body is so developed. Jiva Goswami was giving solution. Actually, 11 years, some months, Krishna actually stayed there in Vrindavan. Actually, Krishna never go anywhere living Vrindavan. It is Siddhanta. But still, externally, we can find Krishna gone to Mathura. Huh? So there, what you can find? Those who are in the case, son of a king, his body is so developed. So, bayo kaisarekam dhiyam. Vangshi vibhuchita karat navani radava pitambara daruna bimba phala darostad purnendu sundara mukhadara bindanavad krishnat param kimapi tatyamaham na jane krishnat param kimapi tatyamaham na jane. I cannot think I cannot see any tattva who is just equal to or greater than this tattva. Bangshi vibhushita karat navaneera dhavat is playing on bangshi, playing on fruit, and navanito makhan is there, clarified butter is there. I mean butter, not clarified butter. Butter is there. Bangshi vibhushita karat in hand. Bangshi. Three kind of. One is big, one is medium, one is small. Benu is small. Gopal, you can find Benu. Well, as he grow up, Bangshi. This way. So now you see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking, you are teaching nicely. I get nice idea from you. So, Sama eva param rupam bayo kaisarakam dhyam. Well, you are giving nice idea. Very nice, Siddhanta. And which dham is the best? Then Raghupati Buddha. Bara mathura puri bara. Bara, bara means srashta, excellent. Mathura puri. Mathura means ma. Mane total. Mathura is a full district actually. Full. Vrindavanda. Bara Madhupuri Bara. Bara Madhupuri Bara. You asking about Dhamma? Who is that? Excellent? Bara Madhupuri Bara. So nice. The same Siddhanta you get. What? As per Gaudiya Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Matmidam, I told you. What is that? Brajabodhivargana Jagalpita, there you find. There also. Same Siddhanta. Huh? What Siddhanta you got? Tadhyama Vrindavana. Nice Siddhanta, same Siddhanta coming, no different. So after that, Mahaprabhu asking, Sama eva param rupam bayaha kausarakam dhiyam bara madhupuri vara. I mean, baya kausarakam dhiyam bara madhupuri vara. And which rasa you think excellent and prime rasa, original rasa? Then Raghupati Bhaiya teaching. Syam eva param rupam bayoho kaisarakam dhiyam bara madhupuri vara addaye eva paro rasa. Addaye eva paro rasa. Adda rasa. What do you mean by adda rasa? Then I go back, I like to go back to Bhagavatam first. Yanma adda soyato anmaya ditarascharta savika sarata tene brahma hidayo adikavaye muhyanti yasurayo teyo vari midayata vinimayunti saragahamsa namna sanna seno sada nirasta kuhakam satyam param dhimahi. Satyam param dhimahi. Satyam param dhimahi. Addo, there. Now, when I explain Bhagavatam, then you will have to hear this point. If you speak janmadasa yata, then first meaning what coming? Janmo adi asyo kasyo visyasyo yasmat. What meaning? Janmo adi. Janmadasso, yan janmo adi asso, kasso, vishasso. Yasmat, jisse hota hai. Yasso, yato, jasso, yeno, yato, yasmat, jasmo, yadyad, yatha, yada. All case ending of karak. Karak, you know? Karak, you don't know. You are Indian. You don't know karak? Is a case ending in grammar. It's all you should put question. Why? What? Whom? How? Then all question comes. This is what kara in Bhakaran. So nice grammar. You think it complicated? Very critical. So, if you could question, oh, answer you can get, Krishna is there. You can finally, you can find Krishna is there. Baba Esche, he is my father, coming. Yatro yeno yato yaso, yasmai yad yad yatha yada. What is it? Yatro yeno yato yaso, yasmai yad yad yatha yada. So all case ending in karak vibhakti. Why? What for? Whom? From where? How? All you put the question. Ultimately, you can find one single answer. Single answer, that Krishna is the original reason behind everything. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, last time when going to stop his teaching, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spoke same thing. Whenever he is interpreting, giving interpretation, I mean Sanskrit grammar, any dhatu, like as, gam, any dhatu, Mahaprabhu going to explain, ultimately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to establish Krishna at the end. Then all students again, Prabhu, Gurudev, you explain this way. Every time you explain dhatu, shabda, all you ultimately you prove that Krishna is there behind. Well, I'm speaking right. Can you prove that I'm speaking wrong? No, we cannot prove wrong. We cannot prove his song is right. Jato yeso, jato yeso, jaso, I already spoke. I learned to. So all you can get, the answer ultimately, answer Krishna is the original root. Scientific research, this is the procedure. If you want to do research on any subject, first you will have to start with some cause and effect. Why this happened? And you find, okay. Next, you can go back to, oh, this is, that is why it happens. Then after that, you can do, why this happened? Then again, you trace out the reason. Oh, for this, it happens. Then again, you find out why this happened. If you trace out all reason and go back to the original reason, you can find Krishna is the supreme cause of all causes. Cause and effect, scientific matters. So now you find, understand? Shyam eva param rupam bayoho kaisarakam dheyam bara madhupuri vara adyeva paro rasaha adyeva paro rasa yanmadasu yatu anmayaditvara swartha saviga sarat. Just now I told full sloka. Yanmo adi janma adi kasso vishasho yasmat, from whom we get this material world. Yanmo adi yasso. This way I can explain, because I am not in a position to explain the Janmadasal Shloka. I like to point out this point. Yanmo adi yasso kasso Vishwasho. Or if I can interpret, explain this way, Janmo Adyasho. Janmo Adyasho. If I split this way, Janmo Adi Kasho Vishwasho. This way I can explain. Or if I can, if I like to explain this way, Janmo Adyasho Yato. Understand? You don't understand. Very critical grammar. Very nice. Only you will have to make sandhi, I mean two words, sabda, when combined, get combined. Brajo yukto isho, brajesho, in grammar, Sanskrit grammar. Two sabda when combined have some grammatical rule you will have to follow. Arbitrary you cannot do it, whimsically you cannot do it. Follow my point. So now if I explain this Janmadasa sloka this way, Janmo Adyasya Yato Yasmat means mane Adya Rasa, the prime rasa, the original rasa coming from the Supreme Lord. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu clapping, oh Raghupati Upadhyaya, you teach me nice lesson, excellent idea I get. Sama eva paravarasaha, sama eva param rupam, vayaha kaisarakam dekam, deyam, varam madhupuri vara, adva eva paravarasaha. Now you have an idea. Adhvarasa means, now if I go back to Chaitanya Lila, tomorrow I can explain that how this slok you can apply here, 100%. 100%. How you can apply this sloka here, a Chaitanya Lila, tomorrow I can explain very scientific way. You can laugh and dance. Yes. Now, today what time now?
8:50.
Huh? Okay, a little bit. So now you can understand what I mean to say. Adiras, and in Chaitanya Charitamrita already you can find, Ami bina braja prem dite nahi shakti. Nobody can give braja prem except me. Varaha sarup, Nisinga sarup, Ram sarup. Tvam bhakti yoga paribhavita hit sarujasase sutekshita patanonanat pungsam yad jad dhiyat urugaya vibhavayati tattad vapu pranayase sadanu grahayo. Then he put that question, Bhad Maharaj, those who are Rambhakta, Siddha Mahatma, they are Siddha Mahatma. Siddha means sadhan siddha, nitya siddha. Those who are nitya siddha, they can come with Ramchandra and go away. And those who are sadhan siddha, also they can worship Ramchandra because they are getting that kind of test. That kind of test they are getting. But about Gauriya Bhakta, you must remember, they are going to get only this excellent rasa. Excellent rasa. Because it is originally tested by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu distributing at the same time testing. The rasa which is not at all tested in your whole life, how dare you distribute it? You test it? You test it? No? Then how you can give? First you test yourself. Then you try to give. If it is not tested in your own life, how you are going to distribute the rasa to others? You cannot do it. So now what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, Adya Eva Paradasaha, that is the prime ras, original ras. Originally, it is prime. Adharas, that's it. Adharas, what do you mean? Madhuras. Adharas mean madhur. Very vital discussion. Very vital discussion. Adharas mean madhuras. Even we can categorize. Because somebody can have love for Krishna as a wife of Krishna. Those who are staying in Dwarka, they are all wives of Krishna. They all are the wives of Krishna. Then what's wrong with it? Well, they have also madhurasa, but that taste is totally different. And when Krishna gone to Mathura first, they are gopikas, they have that kind of tasting. Well, that's why Madhavendra Puribhadra day I told you, Madhavendra were crying, Oi Dindyatanat, Oi Mathuranat, Kadavalaka Shahidan, Tadaluku Katana told you. Madhavendra Puribhad, expressing this kind of Baba. I mean, Raganuga, excellent. Ragatmika, Raganuga, same term actually. So, this is the Baba originally develop into the heart of Radharani. I mean already there in Radharani. By chance, by the mercy of Radharani, that Baba flourish into the heart of Madhavendra Puribhad. It is written. And then Madhavendra Puribhad crying in this way, Hey man, Dindyadu Nade Mathuranath. Mathuru Viraha Varajvasi, their seva, our ultimate objective. It's true. I started with this point, Prabhupada. Mathur viraha brajavasi, Their seva is your ultimate goal. Then you can get this prime rasa, madurasa, all after. You can get. So madurasa. Madurasa you can get. And in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in his own life, I can show you tomorrow, how this madurasa you can find in the life of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I like to discuss both negative and positive point. Because negative point, if I don't discuss, someday you can go down. How cautious, how careful Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is. I know this point. Anarpita charing chirata karunavathara karo samarpata unnata ujjalarasam sabatthi sriyam harihi puradhundaradhudikadam basandivita sada hidayakandara spurutubha sisachinanna. Sometimes spurutubha, sometimes spurutu, no. Same thing. Bhami asmakam hidayana, yusmakam hidayana. All same, meaning same. This sloka I know. But still, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared here to give this rasa. Manjari Baba. But you have to discuss all in detail. About this restriction. How strict restriction there with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Jagadananda Pandit, I told you to read. Repeatedly I told you to read. What? Prembivarta. There it is written in Bengali. Sadhupa kolikale sadhupa kothin janiya sadhukuru rupe krishna ailano diya. Krishna already aware of this factor that pure sadhu is almost rare in this material planet. Though still there, but it's rare. It's rare, almost rare. That's why Krishna thought, I must go to this material world. I can descend as devotee. I can exhibit the mood of Sankirtan. I can also exhibit ultimately the mood of Viraha. Kadachit misra vase vajabadishvatasya gurabirahat. Sratat si sandittat adadat adhikadarugam bhujabadu ka ka vikala vikala gada gada baja luthano bhumau. Very nice sloka. This is the first exhibition of Raganuga Bhajan by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in this Navadvipa. Kadachit Misravasa, in the house of Jagannath Misra itself, Jagannath, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibited. Everybody think he has gone mad, developed some craziness, or doctor came, applying medicine, putting water on head, Swachi Mata crying, my son, my boy gone out of order, who can protect? Then ultimately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asking Srivas and Gadadhar, what you think about my craziness? Then Gadadhar speaking, Siva speaking, Prabhu, the reason for why you appear in this material world, descent, that's the starting point. That's the starting. We know to distribute that thing, you are coming. Ami bina brajo pem ditane, so nobody can give. Ram Sarup cannot give. Barao Saro, Misinga Saro, nobody can give. Solo Kala Purno, 16 fools, fool Krishna. That even Nandanandan Sri Krishna. Only Nandanandan Sri Krishna can give prema. Rupa Goswami was writing, Bina Krishna, without Krishna, who is there? Who distributed prema among all creeper, keeper, lata, gulmo? Who is there? Can you point out? Rupa Goswami said, except Krishna, who is there? Who wanted to distribute this rasa, prema to all, you see? creepers even, all creepers, everything, lata, pata, creeper. Who? But now we can speak very boldly. Yes, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there. Well, what wrong is it? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna all same. What new? Same Siddhanta coming. Ami Vina Krishna Prem, Braja Prem, Dithanayi said. Braja Prem, nobody can give. That's why Supreme Lord, I mean Nandanandan Sri Krishna himself coming in the form of Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. So all the same Siddhanta. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu distributing Prem more big way. Without any restriction, patra patro vicharanam na kurute na sa param bhikshate dya deva vimarsaka na hi nava kala pratiksha prabhu. Tomorrow I can discuss this. You have no pot? You have no pot to take rasa? Come on, I can give pot and rasa also. I can give both pot. You don't have pot? I can give pot and rasa. Both I can give. So this way, you can find how successful Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Just a few minutes ago, I told you, prasarito prema piyusa rasa sagare chaitanya chanda prakatejo dina dina evasa. I can discuss this point tomorrow. Today I like to stop this point. Tomorrow I can like to discuss. If you all bless me, I can. Vancha kalpataru se ke basindu bhavacha patitanang pavana bhavishnabhyo namo namah. Any question? No, I give all answer to all questions. If any question is there, I can feel you have question. Give answer. No question.